Against them, make ready your strength to the utmost of your power, including steeds of war, to strike terror into the hearts of the enemies of Allah and your enemies, and others besides, whom you may not know but whom Allah doth know. Whatever you shall spend in the cause of Allah shall be repaid unto you, and you shall not be treated unjustly.
Towards peace. Do thou also incline towards peace and trust in Allah, for He is the one that heareth and knoweth all things.
من أجل ذلك كتبنا على بني إسرائيل أنه من قتل نفسا بغير نفس أو فساد في الأرض فكأنما قتل الناس جميعا ومن أحياها فكأنما أحيا الناس جميعا ولقد جاءتهم رسلنا بالبينات ثم إن كثيرا منهم بعد ذلك في الأرض لمسرفون
Surely those who disbelieve in our revelations, we will condemn them to the hellfire. Whenever their skins are burnt, we will give them new skins. Thus they will suffer continuously. God is Almighty, Most Wise. Let me tell you who are worse in the sight of God. Those who are condemned by God after incurring His wrath until He made them as despicable as monkeys and pigs and the idol worshippers. These are far worse and further from the right path. When they continued to defy the commandments, we said to them, "Be you despicable apes." You have known about those among you who desecrated the Sabbath. We said to them, "Be you as despicable as apes." And when you meet in regular battle those who disbelieve, smite their necks. And when you have overcome them, bind fast the fetters. Afterwards, either release them as a favor or by taking ransom, until the world lays down its burdens. And if Allah had so pleased, He could have punished them Himself, but He has willed that He may try some of you by the others. And those who are killed in the way of Allah, He will never render their works in vain. They wish that you disbelieve as they have disbelieved, then you become equal. Do not consider them guardians unless they mobilize along with you in the cause of God. If they turn against you, you shall fight them, and you may kill them when you encounter them in war. You shall not accept them as guardians or supporters. Exempted are those who join people with whom you have signed a peace treaty, and those who come to you wishing not to fight you nor fight their relatives. Had God willed, He could have permitted them to fight against you. Therefore, if they leave you alone, refrain from fighting you, and offer you peace, then God gives you no excuse to fight them. You will find others who wish to make peace with you and also with their people. However, as soon as war erupts, they fight against you. Unless these people leave you alone, offer you peace and stop fighting you, you may fight them when you encounter them. Against these, we give you a clear authorization.